I'm the bad guy.
Duh.
And I am back here in the fandom zone. And today, I will be talking to you about the single most important movie of the year that you will want to watch. The movie that will tell all of the trials and tribulations that women have struggled to in their lives. The terrible atrocities that are being done in the movie Bombshell. I'm just messing with you. I will be revealing Bombshells. I'll go over my pros, my cons, my overview, and what I think of this movie, and whether or not Zod approves or Zod disapproves. So, let's jump right into this. This movie was difficult. This movie was difficult because, despite the fact that people will be saying this is an SJW narrative, you would be wrong. This is not an SJW narrative, and I will explain. But first, let me go to the overview. The overview is that there was a powerful man at Fox News named Richard Ailes. Ailes ran Fox News, but the powers to be above him that are higher are also important. And it tells the story of Megyn Kelly and Greta and... Margot Robbie's character. She's, like, unnamed. She's pretty much not important. But these women go together, and they go to bring charges against the most powerful man in probably the field of newscasting ever. Now, here's the interesting thing that made this movie so hard for me to review. As much as you would want to say this was SJW nonsense, you would be wrong. This actually makes men and women look bad. And you're probably saying, Zod, did you bump your head? Were you hit by an asteroid? Let me explain, my good people. Through these narrations, you get a perspective of what the women are thinking as they're being propositioned and they're in these things. And there's even some women in the corporation that admit that sleeping with people, they slept with them to get ahead, and they have no regrets about it. And I'm watching going, I can see why the media is bashing this. It was a very interesting both left and right feeling to this movie. I don't feel it was in the center, but I don't feel like it was too far left or too far right. It was a weird place. The story is true. I mean, there's recordings and things and accounts of witnesses. I mean, too many to discredit. I mean, I could discredit people who said they seen stuff, but there is physical recordings of his voice and recordings of security footage of him saying the things that he says in the movie. It happened. And I think it's kind of weird on one side to call out narrative and then to not call out things that are legitimate cases. The interesting part about this is I probably identified most with Charlize Theron's character as Megyn Kelly. Now, I'm very sure in real life, the narrative is completely different, but Charlize Theron is a hell of an actress and really does invoke feelings and emotions there. Margot Robbie is good, but I kind of felt like she was thrown in there just as a perspective for the audience, rather than having any relevance to the core story. And I hate Nicole Kidman with a passion, but she plays a good bitch, so I'll give it to her. My problem with this movie is not that it doesn't tell a true story, but it almost doesn't have the guts to tell all of the story. I followed this very closely, and there was a lot of things that if they wanted to take a jab at these people, they could have taken advantage of, and they didn't. They kind of give you a bare bones of what happened and the key players, but they miss opportunities. They do dive also into L's, and they kind of also make him a sympathetic character, because when you see where he's came from and why he is the way he is, you almost identify with him. And Jonathan Lithgow is a great actor. John Lithgow has been around in years, and he plays the role perfect. And it had me saying, this guy's a prick. I mean, the movie, to me, doesn't pick a side. It actually just tells a story. If you go in to see this, you know you're gaining from the female perspective. Now, there is a couple of things they throw in there, clearly for the narrative, but it's not as heavy as one would think. There's a whole arc with, I'm sure, a person who doesn't exist, who's a lesbian, who's afraid of coming out because she works at Fox, and she doesn't want to say. But it's very interesting because they have actual taped audio of these different people talking the way that they were talking, and it does make you curious about the things that are being said. And let's be fair here. There are times where the media and the SJW narratives are put into stuff where you go to see, like, Terminator and you're watching a political fiasco. This is what it is. It's about the Fox News scandal. You know what you're going into. So saying that it's politically based is kind of stupid, because that's what the movie is. And for that, I can't say it's an SJW agenda. It's telling an actual story about things that really happened. So it was hard to rate. And I had to ask a female unicorn, what she thought of the rating. And at the end of the day, with her guidance and from the female perspective, I gave this a 6.5. I approve this film because I think that there was some wrongdoings that needed to be showed, because you have to have different perspectives to know that this stuff does exist. I mean, this was recorded, actual, real stuff that happened. It's not made up. It's not fake. There's documented accounts. Ailes settled out of court because he didn't want the recordings coming to light, which they did anyways. So, I mean, guilty is guilty. If you did it, then you can't really dispute it. But overall, as far as everything else in the film, I think they took some liberties in certain places too, and threw in some messaging here and there, but that's Hollywood. Overall, this was a weird middle ground. And I think if you're interested in that kind of stuff, it is a very intriguing tale that really scratches the surface, but doesn't have a lot of nerve to go any deeper in fear of pissing off one side or the other. And I think that's its biggest downfall. If it was going to go for the throat, it should have went for it instead of meandering somewhere in the middle. But anyways, that's my take. I approve for someone who wants to get a little bit, and then I would suggest researching into the rest of it as I did, because it's quite a fascinating tale. People, Fox isn't perfect. MSNBC isn't perfect. CNN, at the end of the day, they're all media outlets. Whether they go one side or the other, they're still flawed individuals. And holding a particular station up on a pedestal is just as bad. So, anyways, if you guys like this video, hit that like button. If you're new to the channel, hit that subscribe button. And as always, remember the rule here in the Fandom Zone: kneel before General Zod.
I'm the bad guy.